أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So inshallah العزيز, we will learn ayat number 9, 10 and 11 of Surah Al-Hajj today. The ayat number 9 is basically related to the previous ayat number 8, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about a person who disputes with the people. وَمَنْ يُجَادِلُ فِي اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَلَا هُدًى وَلَا كِتَابٍ مُنِيرٍ. So a person who disputes regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any guidance, without any book, without anything else, without knowledge. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayat is saying about that person, ثَانِيَا إِتْفِهِ, he turns away on his side, walks away. His intention is لِيُدِلَّ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, so he may mislead people from the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says his punishment is لَهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا خِزْيٌ, for him in this world is a disgrace. وَنُذِيقُهُ, and we will make him taste يوم القيامة, on the day of judgment, عذاب الحريق, a punishment of burning. Then in the next ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَلِكَ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ يَدَاكَ, this is because his hands have sent forth what his deeds are. He himself sent forth for himself for the day of judgment. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed, laysa bizullamin lil'abid, is not the one who would do zulm to his slaves and his servants. Then Allah says, wa minan nasi, and among the people, man ya'abudullah, is a person, is such a person who worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ala harfin, on the edge. What does it mean? That he is not sure, he is in doubt sometimes, he is not practicing, sometimes he believes, sometimes he does not. So that is worshipping ala harfin, staying on the edge. فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ, if a good comes to him, خَيْرٌ نِتْ مَعَنَّا, he becomes satisfied with that. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ, and if some trial befalls him, some difficulty comes upon him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنْ قَلَبَ, he turns away, عَلَىٰ وَجْهِهِ, on his face, خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا, for him is the loss in this world, وَالْآخِرَةَ, and in the hereafter, ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينُ, this is a very open and clear loss that he has fallen into. So inshallah we will try to understand the meanings of the first ayat, number 9 of Surah Al-Hajj. The first two words are ثَانِيَا إِتْفِهِ. So let's try to understand these two words. The first word is with these root letters, Tha, Noon, and Ya. The noun and the file from this, first of all, the meaning, this has multiple meanings, but one of the meanings is that turning away. So a person who turns away is called Thanin. The last ya is not written and pronounced. So this is like fa'ilun, but the ya drops out, so tha'anin. The second word is ayn, tha, and fa. Okay. This means to be on the side, like turning on the side or turning on your one side. So, and the noun from this is Ayn, Tua, and Itfun. Okay. Itfun means then on the side. Okay. Now, what we want to do is we want to use a pronoun who. Okay. Which means he. So if you combine these two as mudaf and mudaf ilayh, it will be his side, and the combination will remove one dhamma, so this will become it for who. It for who means his side. Now we are going to combine these two words. This is a person who is turning on his side, okay, which is he's turning his neck or turning his away and going away. Okay, turning on the side means just ignoring, going away. So when we combine these two as mudaf, mudaf ilayh, the way it works here is, first of all, this word, when it becomes a mudaf, the ya comes back, okay, and it becomes thaniya, okay, and in the mudaf, we change this mudaf ila, we change this to a kasra, so it becomes itfi. Now, for the tajweed and pronunciation reason, we also pronounce this dhamma as a kasra. So it becomes itfihi. Thaniya itfihi is a person who is turning away arrogantly on his side and leaving. So that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, that this person who argues, who disputes about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any knowledge, he is the person who is just turning away from the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thaniya itfihi. Then the next word is, root letters are duad, lam, and lam. Dalala. This means to go astray. Dalin, the word that we know, is those who go astray. But if you put an alif before, it becomes a babe of Allah, four letters. And the meaning of these four letters is to mislead someone, to turn someone away from the right path. Okay, so that is adlala, to misguide someone, to send someone astray. Adlala. So there are two people are involved. One is misleading, one is being misled. So that's the meaning of this word. Now, if you want to make a present tense for third person, the rule is that we put a ya in the beginning, and for this bab we put a dhamma on there, okay, and then we keep the rest of the three words. Okay, so this will become duad, and two lams can be written with a shadda, and it will be yo dillu. Ye dillo means he misleads, present tense and third person. So the meaning is that he misleads. Okay. Now we are going to make one change here. And the change is that we are going to put a lam in the beginning with a kasra. This type of lam is called lam ta'lil. And lam ta'lil brings the meaning of so that. Okay? So that. Then by making one more change here and changing this to a fataha, will make the following changes in the English. So by putting the lam ta'lil, we brought the meaning of so that, okay, and with the combination of this lama talil and this thing, the change in the English meaning will be he may. Okay, he may mislead. So Leo Dilla, Leo Dilla with the Fatha and Lam Ta'alil, the meaning becomes so that he may mislead. So that's the word in the Quran. He turns away, and now his intention is that to mislead other people, misguide other people, turn them away or astray from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let's look at the next words. The word is sabala, sin, ba, and lam, root letters. And the word from this, the noun is sabilun. Sabilun means path or road. Sabilun is path. Okay. Then the next word is Allahu. Okay. Okay. So this is Allah. Now we join these two nouns with the, as a mudaf mudaf ilay, and the what it is, simply put an off in between. Okay. Path of Allah. Okay. So when we bring this thing, what changes are made in the Arabic? You remove two dhammas and turn into one. And in the second noun, you take this and make this as a kasra. Okay. So now the word is sabilullahi, path of Allah. Sabilullahi means path of Allah. Now put an an before that. An is a harfajar, and its meaning here will be from. Okay, now harfajar looks at the next noun and changes this dhamma to a kasra. So the word becomes sabilillahi, an sabilillahi, from the path of Allah. So he may mislead others from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the road or from the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is what he is doing. So Allah says now that what is his punishment or reward. So first thing is lahu. Lahu, simple words, lam means, lam with the fatha means for, and hu means him. Lahu, for him. Fi, in ad-dunya, the world. So in the worldly life, for him there is something. And what is that something? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using these letters Kha, Za, and Ya. This means to humiliate someone, to disgrace someone. And the noun form is Khizyun. Khizyun means humiliation, disgrace. Okay? So that's the word in the Quran. So for this person, for such person, in this world is a disgrace and humiliation. So he will be living a life of disgrace and humiliation, a low life in this world. That's one thing. Then Allah says what happens to him on the day of judgment. Okay, which is the word Yawm al-Qiyamati, the day of judgment. Okay, Yawm means the day, and Qiyamah is the resurrection and the judgment and standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, the word before that is wa nuziquhu. Wa means and let's look at the word nuziquhu. So the root letters are dal, waw, and qaf, zawqa. And this means to have some flavor or some interest or all those things. But we are going to make the next word by adding an alif there. Okay. And it is af'ala. Af'ala has the fathas on all of them. And when you have a fatha on the waw, it sounds like an alif. So the word actually is azaqa. Azaqa means to taste, to make someone taste something. Okay. Azaqa means to make someone taste something. Za'iqa is from the same word, same root letters. Okay. Now, when we make a grammar of we do, so we put for that a noon in the beginning with a dhamma. Okay. And then we take these three letters and nufu'ilu. So the grammar is nufu'ilu. So let's do this thing. So noon is bringing the meaning of we, plural, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and present and future. So that is noon. Now after that, these are three letters, dal, alif, and qaf. Okay. Now let's put the harakat. The second letter has a sukoon. The third letter has a kasra, and the last letter has a dhamma here. Now, here is a mismatch again. Alif has the sound of a. And this is the sound of kasra. Okay, so this sound and letter will change into a ya. Ya is the sound of kasra. So we'll put ya here. Okay, now for the ease of pronouncing this, we move the sukoon on this side and the sound of kasra on this side. So this became noziqo. Nuziqo means we will make taste. And then you, who means him. So this is what the word is in the Quran. Nuziquhu, we will, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that, we will make him taste. What is that? On the day of judgment. So what will he be tasting? Let's look at the two words after that. Azabul Hariq. So first letter is ayn, zal, and ba. Azaba means to punish, and the noun from this is azabun. Okay, azabun is the full word with the two dhammas. This means punishment. Then the next word letters are haraka. Haraka means to burn in the fire. Okay. Hariq is the noun which means burning. Hariqun is the full word, so you have two dhammas here. Hariqun means burning. Okay. Now you put al before that. So al will bring the meaning of da. And we'll remove one dhamma. So it will become al-hariqu. So now we have two words. Azabun, punishment. Al-hariqu, the burning. Okay, so this word is al-hariqu. Okay. Now we will combine them by putting an off in between. The punishment of the burning. So that is like combining mudaf mudaf ilay. And the rule is that when we combine by bringing the connection and the off in between, the on the first noun we change two dhammas to one, so it will become azabu. On the second noun we change this dhamma to a kasra. Then we read them together and do not pronounce this alif. So alif becomes hamzatul wasl. Hamzatul Wasl is a little swat sign instead of Hamza. So now you read Azabul Hariqi. Azabul Hariqi. The azab or the punishment of the burning. Okay, now two more things. So this is what we have so far. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using the word Nuziquhu. We will make him taste. So Allah is doing this work on this person. So Allah is fa'il. Okay. The work which is being done is maf'ul. So when a work or a word come as a maf'ul, then we change the dhamma to a fatah. So this becomes azabal hariqi. When you stop at the ayat, you do not pronounce this kasra. Instead, you pronounce a sukoon. So it will be azabul hariq. And also in the tajweed, qari stretches this ya a little bit when he stops. If he doesn't stop, then he will continue hariq. But if he stops, he'll stretch on that one. So that is basically the meaning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that this person has turned on his side, which means he has left the truth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His intent is that he may mislead and misguide the people from the sabilillah, the path of Allah. So for such a person, in this dunya is khizyun, is a disgrace, is a humiliation. That is the punishment in this worldly life. In the hereafter, on the day of judgment, Yawmul Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Nuziquhu, we will make him taste azab, a punishment of the hariq al-hariq, the punishment of the burning. So this is what is the explanation and meaning and breakdown of the ayat number 9 of surah. Okay, so the next ayat, number 10, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Dhalika. Dhalika means this. This means all this that will happen to this person in this worldly life and hereafter. Bima, because, for what? For that reason, that what did he do? So what are the words after that? Qaddamat. Let's look at these words. Qaf, Dal, and Ma. Qadama means to step forward or Qadam. But when you put a shadda on the middle letter, it becomes Bab Fa'ala, Bab number 2, and the word is Qaddama. Qaddama means to send something before, ahead of you. Qaddama. So if you are sending something for yourself ahead of you, that is what's the meaning of Qaddama. So if we put three fatahs, it becomes he sent for. Okay. Qaddama, third person, he sent for. Okay, or it sent for. Okay. So that is the meaning of Qaddama. Let's just write down it or he sent before. Okay, now let's look at this word. Ya, dal, ya. Yadun or yadan means one hand, yad. Okay, one hand is yadan. If you have, you want to say about the two hands, then the grammar or the vocabulary of two words is yadani. Yadani means two hands. Okay. So if now we add a ka. Ka means you. Okay. And we want to combine. This is a noun and this is a pronoun. We want to say two hands of you. which means your two hands. Okay? So how do we combine? Pronoun don't change, but in the noun, the sound of noon or noon drops in this case. So this word becomes yadaka. Yadaka. Yadaka means your two hands. Ka means you, single person. Your two hands. Okay. Now, because, okay, the other thing is that the body parts are feminine. So this is a feminine word. Now, how do we make a feminine noun, the grammar of this word? Fa'ala, he did. Fa'alat, you put in ta at the end, it becomes the grammar of feminine. Okay. So this word becomes qaddamat. Qaddamat, she sent something, okay, before. So this word is now a feminine. Okay, somebody who is feminine sent before. Okay, yadaka, your two hands are feminine, as I just said. So we have to use the grammar of the feminine. Okay, one thing. Number two, when you are saying qaddamat, that simply means it a feminine, something sent before. But after that is this word, your two hands. So this word will replace this it. Okay? And the meaning will be your two hands sent before. Allah says that this punishment that you are going to suffer in this world and in the hereafter is because your two hands have sent for before, which means whatever deeds you did, those were written with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and because of those deeds, today you are suffering the punishment. So this is the earning of your hands. This is what your hands have earned and sent before you came to the hereafter. So that is the meaning of qaddamat yadaka. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is emphasizing that whatever punishment you are receiving, it is your own hands that have earned it. Allah is not the one who does wrong to the people. So that's the next part of the ayat. Wa anna allaha. Anna means that or indeed. And anna changes the noun from Allah to Allahu to Allaha. So that's the reason you are seeing wa anna allaha, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The word laysa. Laysa means is not. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not. Okay, is not what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using the word zalama. Zalama means to do wrong or to do zulm. Okay. Zalim is someone who does wrong. But the word zalam, which is written this way, zalam, is a bigger wrongdoer. Okay. Zalam, okay. Zalam means someone who is a bigger wrongdoer. Okay. And if you write this alif as a short alif, then it would look just like what's written in the Quran. Zalam, the full word is Zalamun. Okay. Zalimun is just this, the easy word. Zalamun is a bigger wrongdoer. Okay, so that is the word Zalamun. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling for himself, about himself, that he is not Zalam. He is not a wrongdoer. He is not a big Zalim. Okay, And the word before that is B, which is a harf jar, which means off or with. Okay, this is harf jar will change to the mass to a kasra. This is the sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he is not zalim. And ba here is a ba za'ida, okay, which really doesn't bring any meaning, but it is telling that this is not the sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the reason this ba is placed here. So that is this word. The next word is lil abid. Okay, abada means to be slave or to worship. Okay, this word abid is a plural, and full word is abidun. Abidun means slaves, and this is the state when people will be standing on the day of judgment in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that situation, that status of the people is the abid. Okay, in general we can translate it as slaves, but that is when people will be standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is when in this world it can be used, used for the servant or a worshipper. Okay, but that is the slaves standing off in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you put al before that. Al will change one to the mas to one. Al abidu, and the meaning will be the slaves. Okay, then you put a lam with a kasra. Okay, it means four or two. Okay, and lam is a harf jar, so harf jar will change this dhamma to a kasra. And when you pronounce, you do not pronounce this alif, so this alif hamza will change into hamzatul wasl, a small swad, which means do not pronounce. So the word becomes lil abidi, to the servants, to the slaves. Allah is not oppressor, Allah is not zalam, Allah does not do wrong to his slaves. They are the ones who have done wrong, and they have brought that wrong with them, or have sent before them for the hereafter. So that is the meaning of zalamin lil abidi. When you stop, you say abid. Also, when you pronounce this lam and sound of noon together, then it is pronounced as bizalamil lil abid, not min lil abid. Okay, so that's what the meaning of this ayat is. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about another person. Okay, and the word is alif noon seen. It's a commonly known word, insun. Insun means a person, a single human being. Insun. Its plural is nasun. Nasun means pupil. Okay, then you put al before that. Da. Al will remove one dhamma, so it will become al naso, and noon is a shamsi letter. It will kill the sound of lam, and it takes its own sound twice. So you put pronounce noon twice, don't pronounce lam. Annaso. Annaso means the pupil. Annaso means the pupil. Then you put a min. Min means here among. Among the pupil. Among the pupil. And when you pronounce them together, you do not pronounce this alif in between. This alif becomes hamzatul wasl again. But in order to connect these two, because there are two sukoons, we have to change this to a fataha. And now it will be minan nasi, because lam was already gone. Minan nasi among the people, and Allah is saying that among all the people, there is someone. Man. Man means who or he or someone. What does he do? What that someone does? Abada means to worship. Okay? If I put a ya in the beginning, that is the grammar of third person plural, third person and present tense. Yaf'alo, he does. In this case, it is ya'abudu. Ba carries dhamma in the middle. Ya'abudu, he worships. Someone who worships. Okay. Worships whom? Worship Allah. The word is Allahu. Okay. But the person is the doer. He is worshipping. Allah is the maf'ool. He is being worshipped. When the noun comes as a maf'ool or as an object, then it changes last letter from dhamma to a fataha. And then when you recite them together, you combine ya'abudullaha, you don't pronounce the alif, and alif becomes hamzatul wasl and it has a small swad on it. Ya'abudullaha, he worships Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So among the people, there is someone who is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now in the next two words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is defining how is he worshipping. So these are the root letters Ha, Ra and Fa, Harafa. Noun is Harfun. Harfun mean edge. Okay. And Allah means upon. Allah is upon or on. And it is a harf-e-jar. So harf-e-jar will change these two dhammas to two kasras. So the word will be ala harfin. So this person is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the edge, which means he is not sure. Sometimes he believes, sometimes he does not believe, sometimes he prays, sometimes he does not pray, sometimes he ignores, sometimes he opposes. Ala harfin, at the very edge. Okay, that's what the meaning of ala harfin, that he's not sure about his worshipping, no commitment, no sincerity, whatever he does, he feels at a time he does that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about such a person. Now this person does two things. In this worldly life, he does something. What he is doing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling, fa'in. Fa means then or so, in means if. So now, in if is being mentioned, a shartiya, a condition is being mentioned about him. Okay. Now, root letters for the next word are swad, vav, and ba, sauba. Three letters. We will make babia fala four letters by putting an alif in the beginning, and its sound is Af Allah. So all the fatha sound, so when the fatha sound come on wow, it changes into the sound of alif. Asaba. So that's the word. Asaba means to befall something, to reach something. The word musibat is from the same word, because musibat is the difficulty which befalls upon a person. So asaba means to befall, to strike something, to reach something. To someone, so that's asaba. And obviously, if we just combine them, asaba, it means something befell, it befell. Okay, so something, it or he befell or reached. Okay, just any word you can use is reaching a person, something is reaching a person. Past tense. Okay? Then we put who. who means him. So it reached him. Something is reaching this person. Okay. What is reaching to this person? The higher. Higher means good thing. The full word is higherun. Higherun means something good happened to him. He got something good in his life. Okay. Higherun means good. Now, in this word which is reaching him, if it has two dhammas in the state of rafa'a, this word, this noun will replace this word it. So the meaning will be khair reached him. Something good happened to him. Something good reached him. He got something good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Fain asabahu, and he got something good. Okay, so what did he do? How did he react? The root letters are Ta, Mim, and Noon. Okay, Tamana. Okay, now if I add few letters in them, Alif, another Alif here, and Shadda here, this will become At Ma'anna. Word we know, Itminan. Mutmain, okay, satisfied, okay. So these are the, this is Bab number 12, which doesn't come very often in the Quran. So this word is to be satisfied, and that is exactly the word in the Quran. He got satisfied. When khair reached him, he felt satisfaction. So when you read together with the khairun, then you don't pronounce this alif, you pronounce khairu nit ma'anna. Okay, that means good reached him and he felt satisfied. So that's the word in the Quran. Bihi means with it, with this good thing, he felt satisfaction in his heart when a good thing arrived him or something good happened to him. Okay, now the other case. Other condition, wa in, and if, okay, this word here, asaba, first of all, we just saw that word, asaba, who, it reached him, and this it was a masculine, okay, if something was feminine, then we put a ta. Fa'ala, he did. Fa'alat, she did. So the sign of ta with the sukoon, asabat, is about the feminine. So if something feminine, khair was masculine, but now something feminine is reaching him. So that's the reason we have to add this ta. Now why feminine? Fatana means to test, to try. Fitnatun is the word which means trial. Fitnatun. Ta marbuta is the sign of feminine. Okay? So this word fitnatun, trial, a test, is a feminine word. So we have to use the feminine grammar here. Asabathu. Okay? And now the same thing you can replace, because these two dhammas, the it, so the meaning will be a trial befell him, a hardship struck him, some difficulty test reached him. Okay, asabathu fitnatun. So what happens when he gets the good thing? He feels satisfaction. But when some difficulty arrives him, what does he do? In qalaba. Qalaba means to turn the heart, you know, that keeps turning, qalaba. Okay. If you put in before that, this is another bab, in faala, it comes in qalaba. Inqalaba means to completely turn over. The word inqilab is from there. So what happens? Inqalaba, he turns. He just goes away. How does he turn? Ala wajhihi. Okay. Ala means upon. Is a harfajar. Waj, waw, jim, ha. Wajaha are the root letters, and from there noun will be wajhun. Wajhun has one of the meanings as a face. Face. Then we add a hu, which means he, and we combine these two. This will become wajhuhu, his face. Mudaf mudaf will be wajhuhu. Okay. His face. And Allah is a harf jar. Harf jar will change wajhu to wajhi. And in order to pronounce it with the consistent sound of kasra, we pronounce this as a he. Wajhihi. Allah wajhihi. He turns away. He turns on his face, which means he completely turns away if a difficulty falls upon him. If a good thing comes, he's happy. If difficulty comes, instead of being patient or asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for help, he just turns away on his face. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that what his reward is. Khasira, khasin ra. To loss, to be in loss. Khasira, he fell into loss. Fa'ala, he did. Khasira, sin carries kasra in this case. Khasira, he is in loss. He has been completely lost. In dunya, khasira dunya. This dunya is lost for him. Wal akhirata, and the day of judgment, he is also going to be a loser. Okay, straight words. Zalika, Allah says this. This means this loss for him in this world, in the hereafter. Hova, that's what it is. Hova is going to be, that's what it is. The next word, again, the root letters are Kha, Sin, and Ra, to be in loss. Okay, to lose something. Now, there is a template that if you have these three letters, for example, Rahama, that means to have mercy. But if you put Alif and Noon with that, Rahmanun, okay, this brings an intensity of the mercy in a person. Okay, Tufan, same thing, Tughyan. Tufan has the intensity of the weather. Tughyan is the intensity of the flood. Okay. So Khusran is the intensity in a person with a big loss. The person is a big loser because it is a very intense loss for him. So that is the word Khusranun. Then you put Al. Al will make it Al-Khusranu, the Ar-Rahmanu, okay, so Al-Khusranu, so he is a big time loser, and that Khusran, that loss is, Allah says, is Mubeen. Mubeen is from the word Bayyana. Bayyana is something which is very clear, which is manifest. So this person is in a very clear loss in this world and in the hereafter. So inshallah we'll stop. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept this from us. Sadaqallahul